Hi everyone. In this video, we'll show one option for persistent storage on Convoy, which is Portworx. By default, when you deploy Convoy on AWS, you can leverage the AWS EBS CSI driver to get highly available volume. But when you deploy Convoy on-premise, by default, you just get local persistent storage. And one option to get highly available persistent storage is to use Portworx. So you'll see in this web page we have many different partners, and we are focusing on this one that time, but I'll create other videos for other partners. And you have documentation available about how to deploy Portworx on Convoy, like you have documentation for other ones. So let's start with deploying Convoy cluster. So we just do like Convoy init to get a cluster definition file. So it creates a cluster.yaml file that you can edit. We'll still deploy it on AWS because it's just easier for the demo, but generally you would use Portworx on-premise. And here you have different add-ons that are deployed when you deploy Convoy. So what we'll do is that we will disable some of them. We'll also, for the moment, disable Elasticsearch and Prometheus and so on, so that we can deploy Portworx and then enable them so that they also use highly available persistent storage, which is better. So Kibana, and I should have Prometheus here and the adapter, and finally Fedora for the backup. As you can see, we have many add-ons deployed by default, and it's quite interesting for day-to operations. So I can now deploy my cluster just very easy. Convoy up, that will deploy the AWS infrastructure using Terraform, and then I will deploy Convoy itself using Ansible. In the meantime, you can go on the Portworx website and create a spec file that will be used to deploy Portworx on our Convoy cluster. So we just indicate the Kubernetes version. As you can see, we already support 1.15.2 on Convoy, and we are also specifying we will use on-prem, even if it's deployed on AWS, because I want to show you how it works on-prem. So I will provision by myself additional disks on the Convoy workers, but if you would really be in the cloud, you could have just like let Portworx created the disk for you, but in our case we'll just do that manually. And nothing in special in the network, and on the last tab we just say we want to use CSI. So we just click on finish, and you get that link for the spec, but you can also just download it as you want. Okay, so my cluster is now deployed. I can access it through this UI. So you can see the Grafana add-on is disabled, Kibana is disabled, and so on, because we have not set up Portworx yet. But I can access already the Kubernetes dashboard, and I can also configure kubectl. Just need to run this command here. And what I need to do now as well is to add some storage. So I will add one EBS volume to each of my kubelets. So I have a script to do that. But before, just let's check. Can access my clusters with the CLI. I can. See the version like we discussed before, just adding storage now to it. Okay, so I have one volume attached to each worker. And just before I deploy Portworx, I just want to change the type of service created for the UI so that I get a service type load balancer so that I will be able to access this UI from the external world. And now I just need to run convoy up again. I need to change the cluster.yaml to enable the different add-ons that we have disabled before. So we'll enable Velero, we'll enable Prometheus, we'll enable Kibana. Bits, Elasticsearch exporter, and Elasticsearch itself. And obviously, we need also now to deploy Portworx itself. And you can follow the deployments with the dashboard here. Just refresh that, and by default it goes through kube system. So you see it's currently being deployed, so we just need to wait a little bit. So everything is up and running. So we can create a default storage class for Portworx. And we can also test it out here with creating a pod and just checking that it can use persistent storage. So in this case, this pod will be created under the default namespace. So you see it's waiting for the persistent storage, but the volume claim is there. So it should be available in a second. And it's good. We have now our volume, and we see this persistent volume there, and we see the corresponding storage class there. Also, we have used the service type load balancer, so we should be able to access the Portworx UI. So the lighthouse is there, so this is the URL to access it. And yes. Perfect, we can now access the UI as well. And you see we have like four nodes, already one volume, and we can see also four drives and the volumes with the same, the name is the name of the persistent volume claim. So we can now just go, we have there updated the cluster.yaml to say we wanted to enable the add-on, so we can just run like convoy up now. So it doesn't have to deploy any new pieces of infrastructure. It will just directly go through enabling the new add-ons that will leverage persistent storage. So as you can see, all the other add-ons have been deployed and are now leverage highly available persistent storage like you can see here. It's not mandatory because Elasticsearch and Prometheus can replicate the data themselves, but it just gives you another level of high availability. And if we look at the dashboard here, we can see we have like all the corresponding deployments. We can see all the corresponding persistent volumes there. And now we can also see in the UI that the Grafana add-on is enabled, and you can click on there to see the current state of your cluster. Data is just starting to coming in because we just launched it. Same, you can now access the Kibana dashboard and so on. So as you can see, very easily you can get highly available persistent storage with Portworx. We have leveraged it internally for Elasticsearch and Prometheus, and we have also done one test where we were deploying a simple pod, but now moving forward on this cluster, you can just use persistent volumes wherever you need them. And as you can see, very easy to set up. You can do that on-premise. That would be probably the number one use case. But you can also have Portworx deploy in a Convoy cluster in AWS and do some replication of your snapshots from your on-premise Portworx cluster to the one deployed in AWS. So many different ways of using it, but as you can see, very easy to set up and then very easy to use. Thank you.